Thank you. We are only here for God. We are only here for God. April, you want to say something?
No, I thought
it
was
going
to start singing.
Oh, okay. Yes, we are only here for God. God being all that there is. God being each one of us. God being the world. God being our spiritual mission. We are only here for God. And if we keep that as our focus, we will be less stressed. So I would like to just say a short prayer because it just feels weird to not do that. So if you don't mind, let's take a deep breath with me. Exhale. And as we settle into this moment, this day known as New Year's Eve, the day before the new year, we set our intentions to relax in this moment, to enjoy this moment, and to release anything that no longer serves us. We invoke the presence and the power of the one power, of our spirit team, all the love that there is, and we allow it to envelop us and enfold us. We bless this sacred time together, and may it be just what we all need it to be for us individually and collectively. And we just said thank you, and so it is. Okay, so I have some notes here that I want to make sure I don't forget to go by. But I know we have the burning bowl and the naming ceremony, so I'm trying very hard to be mindful of that and not take you into those services because somebody else is going to be doing that. It's just a little difficult with it being New Year's Eve to not talk about releasing and preparing for the new. That's just the energy that we're in. And so we know that there are many calendars and people celebrate New Year's, different times of the year, spring technically being the real New Year. But we are on this calendar, so we're rolling with it. We have the winter solstice just passed. We have, what day of Christmas is this? I forget. But we're in the middle. Is it the sixth day of Christmas? I can't remember. I lost count. The sixth day of Christmas. Okay. And so there are many people who are still celebrating right now, leading up to Epiphany, and or some people call it Three Kings Day, when the arrival of the Magi and the gifts actually came. So we just give thanks because there's a lot of beautiful energy. It's also, for many, a time of stress. And so many people are trying to relax as best they can because, you know, there's parties, there's get-togethers, and then there's people like me and like some of you who are highly sensitive and really need to withdraw a little bit to recover, I guess you could say. Which some of that is part of the message that I got from Spirit a couple weeks ago. And I'll share that in just a minute. But however we choose to honor this time of year, it is very important to honor it in some way. And so again, I have been doing a lot of reflection this past week. And it's been very helpful. Some things I was just like, why? Show me this, show me that. And then when you are shown yourself, sometimes that's a little struggle to accept, you know, because everything is us in some way, shape, or form. And it's not to allow us to be ashamed of ourselves or feeling bad about what we've attracted into our life. But once we can see how we have attributed to or contributed to our situation, then that's a very empowering for us to take steps to change what needs to be changed, if we can do that. So don't be afraid to look at yourself. We got to look at ourselves. So give me one second as my notes keep seeming like they're moving around. And my message that I have that I want to share, it kind of, I'm going to really have to be mindful how I read it, because I recorded it audio to text. And when I was reading it this morning, I said, ooh, I should have edited that, because some of this is not coming out right. But I'll do the best I can when I go through that. Okay, here's something else I'm going to say. So I really wanted to play songs about releasing, again, because that is very important for us to do this time of year. Many people are saying, and I think I hear this every year, I'm so glad the year is over with. Oh, 2020, whatever, was crap. Blah, 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 blah. And a lot of us did get some crap. But we also learned a lot, maybe. We also got some positive surprises. We have stuck it through virtual gatherings right on through another year. I think I'm very proud of us. I'm not always able to be here every Sunday, but we are still here. So yeah, we do deserve a clap, a pat on the back, a group hug, all of that. Because so many people, you know, you go so long and then it just fizzles away. And sometimes that's what it needs to do. But I am very grateful that April is still keeping us together and working very hard. So shout out to April Marshall, soon to be Reverend Marshall. We send you so much love, and we bless you. We appreciate you, and we behold the Christ as you. Because I know with my technology skills, this is always easy. And to take the time out of your schedule every single Sunday and to keep us together and sending emails, reminding us of things, and playing songs for us, it can be a lot of work. So thank you very much, and I hope you know you are appreciated. So thank you. One thing that I want to do for myself personally is to make sure that I write a gratitude list for 2023, because again, there are so many things that I can list that I did not like, that aggravated me, that pushed me, or I felt pushed me. You know, there's a lot of grief and difficult situations and transitions, and we are still here to tell the story. So we deserve to write a list of things that we are grateful for, that we have enjoyed happening to us, because that will help strengthen us as we move forward. Because in 2024, there are going to be more open doors, and we have to be prepared to walk through them. And the best, one of the best ways to do that is, of course, releasing and being grateful. So keep that in mind. I think before I share with you some of the message that I got, could we play now Karen Drucker, one of my favorite artists? And that one is I Relax and Let Go. So we're still in that vibe of releasing. Or did I give you the wrong one, April? I'm sorry if I did. I may have. You know what? Go ahead and play that one. Says, I Open My Heart. Yeah, let's do that one. I'm sorry.
This one here?
Yeah. Yeah, let's do that one. open my heart, I am healed. We're going to open our hearts and walk through those open doors in 2024. So at this moment, I am going to do my very best to read the message I got. So I'll probably pause and have to translate my own information. So yeah, this was about, I think, 2 weeks ago when I got a little bit of it, and then a little bit more came, and a lot of it I know that I could use for myself, but it did feel like something that many other people could use, because a lot of the information I got was directly, you know, universal. So I'll share with you as best I can, so be patient with me as I work through my grammatical errors. So for 2024, the two words Spirit started off gave me were faith and sacrifice. And I have here, we are being called to let go of people, places, and things that we know doesn't align with our highest and greatest good. So that energy of release. Therefore, we're going to have to sacrifice some comfort for the sake of healing, for the sake of freedom, for the sake of prosperity. It is time for us to get off the hamster wheel and commit to being more disciplined and focused when it comes to our goals, and to allow Spirit to move more freely through us. It sometimes takes faith to make the sacrifices, and really, it takes faith to make any sacrifice, because when we make a sacrifice, it's something that we do sometimes, and we don't always know what the outcome is going to be. That's faith in and of itself. So sometimes the sacrifice may be, I'm not going to go a certain place because I know how that energy affects me, but in the end, the reward is having your peace. So although sacrifice sometimes sounds like a word that may be negative, or I don't know how to explain it, but it's like sacrifice doesn't always come off as something you want to hear, but it doesn't have to be a very big deal. It can be something very, very simple that we let go of to make room for other things that we need or can use or benefit from. Excuse me. Many people who have been struggling and suffering for years and years, yet trying to do their best to heal and uplift themselves or others, will be greatly rewarded. And this is where the tarot came in, as I don't even know what I was doing when I started hearing all this, but for those of you who are familiar with tarot at all, what I visualized was the Wheel of Fortune card, as well as the Tower card. And a lot of times people will see the Tower card as something very scary or whatever, but sometimes it looks like that in the deck. And I can't get to mine right now. But the Wheel of Fortune is pretty much what it sounds like. A wheel turns. We have the wheel of time. We have cycles in life. And sometimes we're on top of that wheel, and sometimes we're not so high on it. And so when those of us who have been towards the bottom of that wheel as it's turning, and it feels like it's crushing us as it's going by, we begin to rise like a phoenix and renew ourselves. And also what I received too in that message was that people who have not had the best intentions for others, for humankind, in whatever way, shape, or form, they will come on the other side of that wheel, because that's how life works. What we do and say has an effect on ourselves and other people. And we are being reminded to be personally responsible for the energy that we put out. So we all know there's corruption going on somewhere in the world all the time. And we would not, do not be surprised if we hear more accounts of people who were like in high positions, that kind of thing, sort of fall off. Information coming out about people that's not favorable because of hidden dark secrets. That kind of stuff needs to happen. I know sometimes in my ministry, I have to deliver messages to people that aren't so easy to digest. But we live in a 3D world where stuff happens, and we have a reality to deal with. And spiritual law states that what goes up comes down. What we give out, we get back. And that is the law for everyone. No one escapes that. So do not be surprised if we hear account after account of many people and they're kind of what we could consider falling off the wheel. And so the tower in tarot is an energy of a very powerful energy, very strong force, and it knocks things out of the way. And when it does that, then the path is cleared for what needs to come. So as healers too, excuse me, let me back up, because see, I got off and it happens like that. that is a part, so I'll get back to that point later. But the wheel is turning. The wheel is turning. So again, we're being reminded to be very responsible for our energy, because it's like that boomerang effect. The way the messages came to me was that it will come quicker and our efforts will be multiplied, whether they are positive or negative. So it's up to us to do with our energy what we should be doing with it, because we will be rewarded however we need to be, because the law is universal. It's not picking one over the other, you know, and we have so much power, again, in what we say and do, and that power comes with responsibility. So we're just being reminded to be mindful of what we're doing, what we're saying, how we're treating people. Being committed to our intentions, and understand that when we set the intention to release, sometimes we have to practice that more than one time. Just because we say today, oh, I release the energy of pain and frustration, doesn't mean that pain and frustration is not going to show up again tomorrow, and you have to tell yourself that again. That's why we call it a spiritual practice, because we have to practice. But when we commit to that intention and commit to, as we will hear a lot, doing the work, then again, our efforts are multiplied and our positive benefits can come back to us even quicker. So people, again, I would say what we would call like the underdog, people who've been laughed at, betrayed, belittled for what seems like unjustifiable reasons, they will rise. They will rise. It's really, I just keep seeing that wheel just turning, like it's a whole different shift coming in, because the world sometimes seems like it's going nuts. And in order for things to get in balance, sometimes that tower has to come and things just have to fall apart for us to rebuild and make it the way it ought to be, make it better, make it more positive, make it more healing for ourselves and others. Also with that, what I got was, excuse me, I need to translate. Okay. We are reminded to focus on being spiritually grounded and protecting, making sure we're doing our prayers, our meditation, keeping our spiritual practice up, doing the things we know to do. Sometimes we fall off the wheel, the wagon, and, you know, we get back on, which is why it's so such a blessing that we are able to gather together, because even if we forget it all during the week, we have this one time to gather with others in that energy to recalibrate ourselves and keep going again. So the energy of not giving up on yourself is also extremely important. Now, this wasn't favorable or what was undesirable, I guess you could say, but I think it's a truth, because I'm sure as human beings, we deal with this kind of stuff sometimes in our life. I know I have. So I can take this one very personally, but along with being spiritually grounded, the energy of the parasitic energy, energetically, where sometimes people have people in your life, I know I've had it, where they may only want to be around you because they want to pull on your energy, and they may not have the best intention, and it's probably because they have some stuff unhealed within them. But that doesn't mean we don't need to set boundaries. And that's been a big reminder for myself, and with, you know, there may be family members, acquaintances, or whatever, but it's very important for us to recognize things for what they are, whether we like it or not. It is, some things are just what they are. And when we recognize things that aren't helping us, you know, it's time for us to help hold some sacred and strong boundaries up so that we can take care of ourselves. Because we are not going to be any good to help anybody if we'll keep allowing people to take from us, and it's not reciprocal. Not saying that, you know, you need to keep a log of every little thing that you do for people. That's not what I'm saying, but I'm sure some of us have experienced that, where, you know, you come across some people and you realize at some point, well, oh, I'm not feeling like this situation or this relationship is balanced. This seems really out of balance. I feel like I'm giving, and I'm being drained, and there's more and more being asked of me, and it's not being reciprocated. We don't need that. We don't deserve that, and we don't have to deal with it. Sometimes that is hard for some of us. I know it has been for me in the past. I know growing up, we were taught, you know, in so many words and by actions too, you know, it's your family, or it's the church member. You just got to do it. The Lord will reward you. We have a brain in our head that God has given us to use sensibly, you know, and that is what we should do with it. We are not serving anybody well if we are allowing people to drain our energy constantly. We cannot take care of ourselves that way. So that is very important, because our energy is very sacred. And once we understand how sacred our energy is, we may not want to share it so openly to so many people. Not to be paranoid, but to be mindful, to be sensible, and taking care of ourselves. So again, there's nothing to make anyone be afraid. It's just Spirit knows that we're living in this 3D realm, and we have to deal with stuff. It happens to all of us sometimes. We have stuff. So again, our smallest effort, or what seems to be our smallest effort, will be multiplied and returned to us in beautiful ways. And again, I feel like quicker than before. So we're frankly being called to have some spiritual fortitude, and be as strong as we can. And being strong does not mean you go at it alone. Being strong means sometimes you just have the wherewithal to say, I cannot do this alone. I am going to have to ask someone for help to do this, so I can make it another day. So taking care of yourself really is all that is what that is saying. So healers, many of us healers, I know I can take this. I know this came for me But I'm not the only healer in the world. We have work to do. We have more work to do. And of course, in balance, we need to do that work. But those of us who are being called in some way to heal, no matter what way that is, we really need to do our work and be more vigilant about it, more intentional about it, and just being committed to our mission. And I have here, I don't know where this scripture comes from, but I know it's a scripture. Count it all joy and be not dismayed when we have difficult situations that come up, because those can be a quote-unquote test of our strength. And again, I have here about reciprocity, what energy we're putting out. I know in ancient Egypt, we talk about the, there's a goddess called Ma'at, which is about truth, justice, balance, order, karma, all of that good stuff. So the energy of morality, knowing what your personal morals are and sticking to them, whatever they are, and taking care of yourself, again, that energy of reciprocity and balance and karma is very important. Taking care of children. I know that's a special message for me. Taking care of children, being mindful, paying attention to them and what they're saying and also what they're not saying. Listen to the message that they're giving us with their silence as well as their words. A lot of children speak through silence, but sometimes they're overlooked because they're not the problem child. They're not, you know, we can often know that a certain child may have a certain situation going on because they're loud, they're rambunctious or whatever. But oftentimes it's the quiet one that's not giving us any problem that has a problem. So if you find any way, any time, any chance, this coming year to encourage a child, please do so. Because they're dealing with a lot. This world they're growing up in now is very interesting. And children are being exposed to so many things that I just can't imagine. Like, I saw enough as a kid. I'm like, wow. You know, because we have technology and they have access to so much. And it's quite a bit that's not very good for them. So pay attention to their nonverbal cues. This is something else that became that came through really strongly was making amends and reconciling. And the caveat with that is make sure when you're reconciling and making amends with people, that it is safe to do so. Sometimes we are encouraged to forgive people, to do this and do that, but it's not always psychologically safe, emotionally safe, or even physically safe. We know that we can forgive people without even saying a word to them. But it did come in very strongly that if it's possible, if it is at all possible to do so. And the main reason, of course, we know forgiveness is for ourselves. To release that burden from our heart, allow our hearts to be open and receive the healing, as Karen Drucker was just singing about. So sometimes we may need help doing that. So if we need to reach out to somebody for help, if we need to go to therapy for help with that, or whatever we need to do, then we can do that. But again, it's to be done mindfully. Some of us who have gone through some things with some people, we know that if we go to that person and say, hey, I forgive you, I want to fight it, it's not going to turn out well because of the mentality that that person currently has. So again, we do it for us, and we need to decide if it's safe for us to do that. And even if we can't reach out to the person directly, we can do it in a burning bowl ceremony. We can start there with our reflection, any journaling that we could do to release those things and let it go. And sometimes taking care of ourselves and reconciling needs to be done within us. And then those boundaries, we may have to set boundaries where we don't talk to certain people anymore, because that is psychologically the best thing to do for us. And that's okay. So mental and emotional well-being is of the utmost importance now and will be throughout this year. Take care of yourself at every level. And do not allow people to encroach upon your boundaries if you can help that. I hope that helps. That's the message that I got that I wanted to share. Because self-care is where it's at. And it's more than just taking a bubble bath. It really is. It really could mean I'm not talking to you ever again in my entire life unless Spirit tells me to do that. Goodbye. That may be what it is. And you can send love and do that. You know, so it's a time, I know for me, it's a time to be realistic with my spirituality, more realistic and really understanding that, you know, not everybody has my best interests at heart, even those people who may be doing some of the same things I'm doing. That's a reality check that we sometimes have to understand, is that just because I'm Reverend Weechi, I could be the most miserable, meanest person in the world. But all you know is I'm Reverend Weechi. You could get to know me. Oh my God, this girl is nuts. I mean, most of y'all know me well enough to know I'm not really that crazy. But, you know, like sometimes we give people a pass because of who they are, what title they hold. We are all divine beings, and no one is better than another. Someone may have more knowledge, more experience, more expertise, and we need to honor that and respect that. But if Reverend Weechi is going down the street, busting out car windows randomly, that's not a good thing. You know? So take that into account. If it helps you, I'm glad. If not, just put it in your pocket and maybe it could be useful for somebody else later. And I want to pause for a minute now and ask for anybody if you would like to share anything. And then we'll do another song and a brief meditation. I realize I did speak way longer than I had intended. So, but I do want to open up space for anybody that wants to share anything.
I'm going to be unpacking that for the rest of the year. The one message mostly reminds me of, I think it was Jesus, he said, dust up your shoes, dust up your feet, your sandals, praise and like they don't want to accept Jesus for what he was, but says, is anybody going to see the light that you may have? And they're going to try to do all that squeezing and get into your boundaries to take your energy anyway. So I like that phrase that said, just don't choose, man. Take your understanding and leave them as they are, let them go, letting go of them, and proceed with your own prosperity. So I always like that, just, you know, what was that about? Like, that's your understanding, is your shoes, your feet, is your understanding.
Yeah.
That's a good model. Thank you, Reverend.
Thank you. Thank you very much for sharing that. I love that. I'm glad you came at it from that perspective. That is so true. Dust off your feet, honey. You don't got time. Anyone else like to share?
I share something too. We, Elliot and I watched a program called The World's Losers, where people live to be over 100 years old. Mm. And I just want you all to know that you're part of our loser, because keeping ourselves healthy with people in our lives that mean a lot are so important to us. And it's really special.
Yes. Thank you. That's so true. Lisa, did you have your hand up? Oh, okay. All right. Okay. Well, I think we can do another song. That's all right. This is April. The I am so blessed. Probably one of my favorites. Let's breathe in this energy and really receive the message that she's given us in this song as we go into 2024. We release what no longer serves us, and we absorb the energy of being a blessing. We are so very blessed. We're going to walk into 2024 with that blessed energy, recognizing the blessing we are to the world, and sharing that. Hey, Winston! So, hey, Winston! So, if it's okay, I would like to do a brief meditation, and I know it's 11 o'clock, so if anybody needs to log off, you know, just do what you gotta do, but if you can hang on, hang on. I don't know, I think when I played music before, everybody could really hear it. I should have sent this to you, April. I wasn't thinking. Let's see. You all could tell me if you can hear it or not. It is called, excuse me, give me 1 second. So if you're comfortable to close enough to close your eyes, please do so. and set the intention to relax. And as always, we're going to take a couple of deep breaths together. Let's inhale. Exhale. Again, releasing anything, everything that no longer serves our highest and greatest good. We set the intention to just let it all fall away. Giving thanks for this precious moment together. Giving thanks for all that we have accomplished, all that we have overcome in 2023. And we release, again, any burdens, any perceived frustrations, any guilt, any shame. We just breathe it out. Just sighing it away, allowing our hearts to be lighter and lighter and lighter. So that the energy of love exuding from our hearts is able to shine and envelop us, comfort us, enfold us in such peace. As we give thanks for all that we have accomplished in 2023. Giving thanks for all the strength that we have gained. Giving thanks that we are still here, giving ourselves another chance. Allowing the breath to relax us, to remind us that we still have the power and the wherewithal to do what is ours to do. We embrace the transition, the change of a new year. And let's imagine ourselves standing in this beautiful room that is so beautiful, but yet very dark. Dark because we are allowing ourselves to go within, to see with the eye of spirit. To honor those parts of ourselves that we may feel are broken. And we send ourselves love in this darkness. Being reminded that as we grew in the womb was dark. The womb of creation is dark. Dark in a way that allows us to grow and flourish. Not darkness that we should shy away from, run away from. Darkness that we should embrace for the creativity that is cultivated in darkness grows within us. So although it is dark, it is a time of nurturing. Seeds grow in the dark, in the soil. roots are established in the dark. We embrace the growth that happens in the darkness. And as we stand in this room, we lift our hearts, our heads, to be open and receptive to all the good, all the growth, all the love that there is. And from our hearts, we give and receive the light. Knowing that the universe is balanced in both dark and light. Yin and yang. Masculine, feminine. So we embrace the balance, being able to see with our spiritual eyes as well as our physical eyes. As our heart is open, receiving only pure positive energy, it is being healed. Grief is being comforted. Pain being washed away. With strength and power from our lessons and blessings remain. We embrace this light. We embrace the darkness. As we are now traveling a new road, only taking along what is highest and best. Stand and bask in this beautiful, glorious light, as well as continue to acknowledge the darkness. Gratitude, with thanksgiving, with poise, with power, we are guided, we are protected, we are safe, we are loved. Continuing to breathe. We allow this light to lead us into 2024, ready to walk down this path, ready to walk through the open doors that are just for us, ready for the wonderful surprises that await, ready to fulfill the goals that we have set for ourselves, ready to show up as who we truly are. As healers in our own right. And so with this love and light, power and strength, we envelop each other, our loved ones, declaring physical healing, emotional healing, psychological healing. When we see the entire world enveloped in this love, this light, this healing energy, we allow ourselves to be removed negative energies. And we focus on what is ours to do. We give thanks for all that we are and all that we share in the world. Every particular prayer request we may have in our heart, every need, we bring it to the forefront of our minds now and allow every request to be surrounded, enfolded, enveloped in this beautiful loving energy. Knowing that all is well. Every need provided. We give thanks to life itself for flowing in through and as us. We give thanks to the elements of air, fire, water, earth, spirit. We honor the plant kingdom, the animal kingdom, the mineral kingdom, nature, in every aspect. We are so very grateful. We are the face of God. We are the embodiment of God, of all that there is. We move forward in love, in peace, and strength. And we quicken our powers of wisdom, will, as we move through any transition in our lives. We have the power to release. We have the power to receive. And we use our power so very wisely. So again, we just envelop ourselves, our loved ones, the entire world, this beautiful, beautiful energy. Thank you, life. Thank you, love. Thank you, joy. Thank you, peace. And thank you for the lessons that we have learned. We welcome in 2024 to be a powerful year, a year that we see changes in our lives that we need. We release any obstacles and we move forward. Seeing that light, lighting our path, seeing those doors opening wide, and we walk through them in confidence and with joy. We are so very blessed. We are so grateful. We are loved. We are loved. We are loved. You to take another deep inhale and exhale. And now we are ready. We are ready to do what is ours to do. in and out. We allow ourselves to gently come back to this current space and time. I welcome you to rub your hands together, rub your arms or your legs, whatever is comfortable for you to allow you to reconnect with the present moment, yet holding on to that beautiful loving energy. We say thank you, thank you, thank you. And so it is. Thank you all for allowing me to be with you today. I'm trying to stop sharing right now. Thank you so much for your loving energy. I really, really appreciate it. And I'm reminded too that 2024, numerologically, adds up to an 8. Which we also see sometimes as the infinity symbol. So, do we have anybody a little well-versed in numerology that would like to talk about the number 8? Lisa, you got anything to say about number 8? Nobody? I'm not a numerologist. But, yeah, thank you. Thank you. The prayer of protection. The light of God surrounds us. We are the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. We are the love of God. The power of God protects us. We are the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. We are the presence of God. Wherever we are, God is, and all is.